So Zeus here, he is magnificent.
Well, Zeus is the breed standard of what a Shih Tzu should look like. Ooh. Because he's got the beautiful top knot, the amazing flowing coat. And let me tell you, when they prance around the ring, they look like they're floating on air.
This is very high maintenance though, right? This is like the Mariah Carey of the dog world.
It's high maintenance, daily brushing, weekly bathing, but what we're asking for is the pet trim, the pet version of this.
This is Mimi, who's in a much more practical haircut.
Manageable Mimi.
This coat has to be dried flat, all facing down, because it's really quite a straight coat. So I want to see really nice, neat scissoring, because it can have a tendency to look a bit choppy.
So what don't you want to see?
I don't want to see a dog which is out of balance. Everything should be symmetrical from the front to the back.
And we really want to concentrate on sculpting their face. So taking it too short around the eyes can make them look a bit startled, but leaving it long will lose that alert and intelligent expression that we're really looking for.
Before you groom a dog, you want to feel your structure. Some Shih Tzus have unusual shape, so it is about making sure that the legs are straight, so you don't have that Charlie Chaplin front where the legs go easty, westy.
Like mine.
I know, or like mine. I used to be a ballerina.
Did you?
No.
So this little teddy bear is Barley, the miniature poodle. Very cute look, isn't it? What are you looking for then in this cup?
We're looking for nice, soft, curvy lines. All the legs have to match. Both front legs got to be big, chunky column legs. Back legs, you want to show that angulation, you want to show the shape to give it that big, fluffy teddy bear look.
I want to see really nice symmetry of the face, so over the top of the head, around the eyes and around the muzzle. And also, this coat is really different to the Shih Tzu's coat. We need to dry this to straighten out all those curls, and then we can create a really nice, even trim.
What don't you want to see, Verity?
We really don't want to see a foot. The leg should be one column all the way down to the ground.
Well, I can't wait to see our groomer's teddies.
The popularity of the poo has grown in the last 15 years since a poodle was crossed with a Labrador to create an allergy-free guide dog, which they called a Labradoodle. Poodles are super intelligent and shed very little hair. Crossed with a Cavalier King Charles Spaniel, they produce the cute Cavapoo. A Bichon and Poodle mix is called a Pooch. And a poodle and cocker spaniel make up the lively Cockapoo.
Us groomers, we have to be ready for any dog that comes through our doors. The small, the big, the giants, the beautiful Zeus, which is right here in front of us. That's right.
Oh, he's beautiful, isn't he? And he's also huge on Insta.
Start following him.
I do follow him. And follow me back. Now, what is the secret to handling a dog this size? I mean, is someone as short as me going to be struggling?
It shouldn't matter what size groomer you are, we have to be able to handle all these dogs. So when I'm handling a miniature poodle, for instance, my body language and everything is very much more coaxing, more gentle, whereas when I'm handling a big Malamute, it's very much more leading and a little bit more authoritative.
Oh, you scared me a little bit then.
Sorry.
Authoritative?
Yes.
Right, so tell me about his undercoat. What's the trick to getting it out?
Well, the de-shedding, this is a huge part of this challenge. Malamutes do have double coats, and it's very important to take out a lot of the undercoat. You want to make sure that your comb goes through the coat with ease.
We want to do minimal trimming on a breed like this. The chest we tidy up and the feet, that top coat, tends to be left very natural.
Yeah, it's such a beautiful coat. You wouldn't really want to get rid of all that.
It's no. Gorgeous.
Zeus, I'll let you get back to your Insta story and blocking cats. And follow me back, please.
Alaskan Malamutes are strong working dogs who were bred to haul heavy loads across Alaska and Siberia. They are closely related to wolves, inspiring the dire wolves from Game of Thrones, and just love to chat and howl. They have double coats, a waterproof one to help protect them from the icy wet, and a furry undercoat to retain the heat. Twice a year, this undercoat naturally blows out, and a groomer can lend a helping hand with a de-shed. Prepare for the hair.
Colin, there is fur everywhere in our Poochie parlour.
I know. Well, this is what happens when you've got double-coated breeds in the salon, blowing the air out, and what it does, it goes into the skin, penetrates it, and then forces the loose undercoat to come out. And you have all this fur snow. These dogs are prone to what we call rising damp. So it feels like it's dry 1 minute and then the water starts to come up the next.
Oh, really?
So it's important that you get right down to the root and you get it bone dry.
Got to a fountain of knowledge, Colin. Let's go back to the snowstorm.